the topic for today is earthworks. So first, let's have a few concepts about earthworks. So earthwork surveying is important, especially in large-scale projects such as residential development, roads, railways, and other government infrastructure. Earthworks usually involve either the removal or placement of soil or landmass on a particular area. Thus, for this purpose, surveyors calculate the volumes of cuts and embankment fields. So later, I'll show you what that is. So based on that, the principal activities in earthworks are the following. First, measuring and calculation of volumes. Excavation, which includes leveling, cut to cross fill, U-cut and borrow excavation. Loading, hauling, and unloading. And then filling, including spreading and compaction. So for our computations, we'll just be computing for area and volume of soil. So let's talk about these activities. First, your excavation. So excavation is the loosening of the soil from its natural in situ stage. We have the following activities under excavation. First is leveling. So this word is used to describe a situation where only a leveling of bumps and depressions is necessary to provide a sufficient width for the road at a uniform level. So this is a pretty basic activity for earthworks. Next, we have cut to cross fill, means that the soil is excavated or cut from one side of the road and used as fill material at the other. For example, here, let's have a close up on this picture. Okay, we have this hill, right? So this portion was cut and then filled to this portion to create your road, hence the cut and fill method. So it's usually used for creating a level space within hills and other sloping surfaces. The next is creating a U-cut, which is just a cut roughly shaped as a U, which is the shape that we'll be using more often in our computations. And then for borrow excavation, suitable soil has to be borrowed from outside when the excavated soil within the road width is not sufficient for a fill or embankment. For example, here, whatever you cut here was not enough to create a level road on this portion. So you're gonna borrow from a different site instead. A great example is the Dolomite Beach, wherein they borrowed from a different place to create that area. Okay, next activity is hauling and unloading. So hauling is the transport of soil. The modes of haulage vary with the distance. So for example, haulage can be done by stretchers, wheelbarrows, animal carts, tractor trailers, and trucks if the distance traveled is pretty minor, okay? Because these are usually done manually. So it would be inconvenient for long distance excavations. Wheelbarrows and tractor trailers are most commonly used for labor-based road construction. For example, here, this is the portion to be excavated, and they're using tractor trailers to move the soil around. In flat areas where the road needs to be elevated, the soil can often be taken from pits alongside the road, which we call borrow pits. So this is an example of borrow pits creating an embankment for the road. And then the final activity is unloading, and it's usually done by tipping. Tipping vehicles can also spread the soil or gravel. So unloading is just the placement of soil on your site. Okay, so that's it for the concepts. Now let's move on to our computations. So once again, the computations that we will do are computation for area and volumes. So this is the typical shape for the areas and volumes computed. So as you can see, it's like a U shape. Right, so this is creating a U-fill or U-cut. The area of this shape is given as follows. So 1/2 times W over 2 times HL plus HR plus 1/2 times C times DL plus DR. So if you've noticed, this is similar to just areas of a triangle, 1/2 base times height. Okay. So 1/2 base, W over 2. So this area times HL plus HR, and this is considering a triangle, and then this is your other triangle. So a shorter way to memorize this equation is area is just W over 4. W is the width of your, or the bottom width of your excavation. HL, HR are your heights on the left and right side. Plus C over 2. C is the height at the midpoint or midsection. Times DL plus DR. DL is the distance to the left. DR is distance to the right. Okay? And then these areas are used for the computation of volume needed for excavation or for fill. So we have three methods of computing for volume. The first method is by end area method. So we call that V sub E for volume using end area method. And that's just L over 2 times A1 plus A2. L is the length between two stations or the two ends of your excavated section. A1 is the area at the front. A2 is the area at the back of the section. Another method is by prismoidal formula. So we call that V sub P. And that's just L over 6 times A1 plus 4AM plus A2. Again, L is the length between your stations. A1 and A2 are your areas for the front and back of the section. And AM is the area at the midpoint of your stations. Later on, I'll show you what that looks like. And then finally, we have volume by prismoidal correction formula. So as you can see here, we have an irregular shape. So if we're using prismoidal correction, we're going to transform the shape into a trapezoid. Okay? So we're going to compute the correction from that by converting our irregular shape to a trapezoid using this equation. So Cp equals L over 12 times V1 minus V2 times H1 minus H2. V1 and V2 are the heights of your trapezoid at the front and back of the section. H1 and H2 are the top widths of your section, front and back. Okay. After computing for that, you just subtract that value from your volume by end area method. Okay, so those are your equations. Let's have some examples to better understand those concepts. So let's have example number one. Please prepare your calculators for faster computation. All right, number one, the cross-section notes shown below are for ground excavation for a 10-meter road. So that's immediately the length of your excavation. So L equals 10. You can write that out immediately. So let's do that. Okay, so at station 25 plus, for number one, you already know L equals 10 meters, okay? And then we have the following cross-section notes. So cross-sections are the back and front portions of your section. So at station 25 plus 100, let's do that. These are your notes. So 7.85, 0, 8.45, 1.90, 3.2, and 2.30. So you might be wondering, what are those numbers? So on the top, 7.85 and 8.45 are the distances to the left and right of your cross-section. So that's DL and DR. 0 just marks the midpoint of your section. 1.90 and 2.30 are the heights on the left and right side of your section. And this 3.2 is the height at the midpoint. So that's your C. Okay, so if you try to draw that, okay, 7.85, 8.45, 1.9, 2.30. So the right side is higher and longer. Well, let's draw it that way. Something like that. Okay. Then midpoint over here. So this is approximately what your section looks like. And then let's write out the values. Once again, the top portions are your lengths. So this was 7.85. And this was 8.4. 55. Okay. And then height on the left or right are 1.9, 2.3. And then here at the center, that's 3.2. Okay. Oh, by the way, correction. This 10-meter width road, and 10-meter road, that's the width of your road. Therefore, that's this width over here. Okay? Yeah, that's the 10-meter one. That's not L, my bad. Okay? So it's not L. The 10-meter width of the road is this portion, W. Okay? And then, the question is, what is the volume of excavation between the two stations using letter A, volume by end area method? Okay, so we're looking for volumes. Looking at the equation, again, volume is L over 2, A1 plus A2. So we gotta get A1 and A2. A1, okay, looking at our stations, this is station 25 plus 100, this is station 25 plus 150. So this is the first station we'll encounter, therefore this is your A1. The area computed from this part is your A1. And then this is the end of your section, so this is your A2. Let's solve for A1 first. A1 has this equation, W over 4, so let's write that out. So A is W over 4, HL plus HR, plus C over 2, DL plus DR. Okay? So, computing for A1, W, again, that's the width, so 10 over 4, HL is height at the left and right side for HR, so left 1.9 plus 2.3 plus C over 2, C is the height at the midpoint, so 3.2 over 2, DL plus DR, that's distance to the left and right. Okay, please compute, what's the answer? Very good. Who got it first? Greg, Gabriel, and John. Okay, 36.58. Store that in your calculator because you're going to use it later. Store. So that's A1. Now I gotta get A2. And A2 just be taken from this data. So I'm not gonna draw it anymore since we got the concept already. Okay. As mentioned earlier, these two are the distance to the left and right. This is height on the left, height on the right, height at midpoint. Okay. So let's use our equation now. W is the same. Width of the road should be uniform throughout all the stations. So that's still 10. So 10 over 4 times HL, HR. So that's 2.9 plus 3.8. Plus C over 4. C is the midpoint height. So 2.6 over 2. DLDR, which is 9.35 and 10.7. Okay, please solve, what's the answer? Correct, KB and Denzel, Lahom Escobar. It's 42.82. Again, store the entire value in your calculator, okay? So for part A, we're looking for volume by end area method, V, okay? And that is L over 2, A1 plus A2. I got A1, I got A2. Now the question is, what's L? Okay, so to determine what's L, I'm gonna draw what's happening here. So we already know this is what the front station looks like, right? And then the back station looks like this. So once again, 10.7, longer on the right side, higher on the right side as well. So it's kind of like this. So let me draw that in 3D. I'll extend that over here at the back. And then like this. Okay. And then okay. So this is at the back end, and this is your station. What was that? 25 plus 150. This front part is your station, and 25 plus 100. And L is this length. That's your L, okay? And so based on that figure, can you tell me what's L? Okay, very good. Denzel and John, first column. It's 50. So L is equal to 50 meters. So for those wondering, how do we get 50? Okay, remember station denotes positioning of your points. So this means station 25,100 meters. This is at station 1,150 meters. So the length of your excavation is just the distance between those two stations. And to do that, just get the difference. So 150 minus 100. So the distance between those two stations is 50 meters. Okay? So that's how we got that. So VE is L over 2, A1 plus A2. Okay, let's double check if that's correct. Yep. Let's sub in our values. 50 over 2. This is A1. This is A2. Please solve. What's the answer? Correct, Sebastian and Gabriel. Crew some fun. Okay. It's 1984. 0.88. 1984.88. These are in meters. So our unit for volume is meter cube. Okay, so that's the first part. Now I want you to store this value in your calculator as well, because you'll see that we need this later. Okay, so that's part A. Next, let's have part B, which is volume by prismoidal formula. Okay. So this is the equation, L over 6, we know L, A1, A2, we know. So the problem now is getting AM. AM is not given. Again, AM is the area, the midsection between the front and back stations. Now, no worries. We can just get the area or interpolate. Okay, so to do so, they're just gonna get the average of the corresponding sections. Okay. So let's get AM. Again, it's just the average of the two. Yeah, area is meter squared. So this is meter squared, meter squared. Okay, so let's look. What's the average of 7.85 and 9.35? Correct, Kian and Geraldine. Kian. Oh, zero. That's 8.6. Okay, so I'm gonna write it here. 8.6, this is zero. What's the average of 8.45 and 10.7? Correct, Carl and Sebastian Cruz Arreglado. Cruz. Oops. Arreglado. Right. So for this, please don't round off. We want the full number, 9.575. Okay, now what about 1.9 and 2.9? Okay, correct. Maria and Kian, Pagalana and Kiben. Pagalana, Pagalana, Kiben. There. It's 2.4. And then I'll finish the rest. This is 2.9. This is 3.05. Okay. And so that's our cross section notes for the mid part. And we want to get AM, and we already know how to solve for that, right? It's using the same equation here. So AM, W is the same. So 10 over 4 times HLHR, so 2.4 plus 3.05 plus C over 2, 2.9 over 2, VLDR, 8.6, and this. Please solve, what's the answer? Correct, KB and Raymar Bernardo Escobar. It's 39.98, and as usual, store. Okay, now we can solve for volume by prismoidal formula, and that is L over 6. A1 plus 4AN plus A2. L is the same, that's 50. Okay. Please solve, what's the answer? Correct, Raymar. And Maria. Bernardo. Pagalana. All right. It's, if you use the stored value, wait, no, there's a correction. What? Okay, thank you. 3.8.
What?
It's 2.3 plus 3.8, not 2.9. 2.3. So it's 3.35. Ah.
Oh.
Oh no, it's 3.05. Yeah. So 2.3 plus 3.8 divided by 3.05. Okay. And then yeah, 6/6. Thanks for the correction. We get the same answer though, right? It's still 1994.29 if you use the stored value. Okay. Meter cube. Okay. Ellen, what? Let me double check. 4.9 plus 3.8 plus 2.6/2 times 5 plus 10.7. Okay. Hold on, I'm double checking. Because I got 2.29. 3.2/2. Yeah. Right, should be 0.25 after recomputing. And then for part C, volume by prismoidal correction, assume 2:1. Okay. So what does that mean? Assume 2:1. So that means that's the slope of our trapezoid. Because remember, for correction, we're converting this irregular shape into just a trapezoidal shape. Okay. So I don't think it'll fit, so I'll use a new layer. So this part, okay. Will be converted to this way. A trapezoid, a regular trapezoid. And then that 2:1 is the slope of the side of your trapezoid. So 2 rise, 1 height. So the width of this trapezoid should be the same as your given, since that's the given width of the road. So this is still 10. And then remember here in our equation, we got V1, V2, H1, H2. Okay. So V1, V2, it's these portions. Okay. This is your V1, height of your trapezoid. This is your H1. Okay? And then this will be the same for the back cross section. So to solve for that, the area computed using this trapezoid should be the same as the area computed earlier when we had an irregular shape. Therefore, and A1 is equal to area of a trapezoid. If you recall, the area of a trapezoid is base 1 plus base 2/2 times height. Now, the problem there is, if I do that, so 10 plus H1/2 times V1, I can't solve for anything because I got two unknowns. So I either have to write V1 in terms of H1 or H1 in terms of V1. And in order to do that, we use this slope. Okay, so So to use that slope, let me divide this into triangles. Okay. So this triangle is similar to this triangle since they share the same slope, right? So therefore, whatever is the height of this triangle, its base is twice that length, right? That's the ratio 2:1. And if you notice, the height of this triangle is V1. Therefore, this length is just twice V1, okay? So it's symmetrical, so same thing on the left side, this 2V1. And as you can see, this middle portion is 10, okay? So instead of writing 10 plus H1, that would be 10 plus 2V1 plus 10 plus 2V1 over 2 times height V1. And remember, we already have a value for A1, and that was 36.58. So equate that to 36.58. Again, use the stored value. And then from this, you can solve for V1. Please solve. What's the answer? Correct, Angel. Celica, who else? And Colleen. Sorry. It's 2.45. And then from this, we can solve for H1. Okay, H1 is just equal to this. H1 equals 2V1 plus 10 plus 2V1. Therefore, what's H1? Correct. Carl, Colleen, Sante Arreglado. Okay, it's 19.82. I store those. Store. And then we gotta do the same for the other or the back portion of the section. So that's V2H2. Okay. So area 2, it's the same. 10 plus 2V1 plus 10. So now we're using V2 plus 10 to V2 over 2 V2. And we're going to equate that to the area we solve for. Here it's 42.82. Okay, so from this we solve what's V2. Correct, Geraldine and Angel. Celica. Lazaro Angel. It's 2.76. Okay, store that. And then you can solve for H2, which is just 2V2 plus 10 plus 2V2. Please solve. What's H2? Mm-hmm. Okay. Correct, Zyra and Luigi Ramos Ortiz. It's 21.04. Okay, and store. Now, we can solve for Cp. Correction using Prismoidal method, and that's L over 12 times V1, V2, H1, H2, right? Yeah. Okay, please solve. What's the answer? Correct. Kian and Denzel. Kiben Lahom. But iba sagot niyo. Again, L is 50. So 50 over 12 times V1 minus V2, H1 minus H2. It's 1.55. Store the entire value of that. And now we can solve for volume using Prismoidal correction, which is just VE minus CP. This is the reason why I told you to store VE. VE is this minus this. So what's the answer? Correct. Jasper. And Luigi. Luigi. 1983. Oops. 0.32. Again, this is volume, so meter cube. Okay, so that's it for number one. Do you have any questions? Pa-solve yung V1 or V2. Okay, let me solve it. 36.58 times 2. Divided by 4 alpha. Yeah, it's 2.45. I just used the stored solve function of my calculator. So I just wrote 20 plus 4V, 4X, since that's what's in the calculator, times X over 2 equals A. A is where I stored this. Shift solve X equals 0. We got 2.45. Because if you solve this manually, I think you're going to go through quadratic equations because you're going to get an x squared. So 4, you can get 2 times 8. There's an x here. Yeah. You can go through quadratic equations. You're going to get a quadratic formula here because you got an x squared or v1 squared. Okay? Any other questions? Obvious not variables tongue store. Then you can just write the entire decimal in your paper. Ma'am, paano ulit yung VC? What do you mean VC? VC or VCT? Ah, VE. Ayan, VE. L over 2 times A1 plus A2. Okay, any other questions? Wala na, okay na. Okay. No questions, let's have the next example. Yeah, this is VE, not VC. E. Okay. Number 2. Okay, a 60 by 60 square lot is to be divided into 9 square sections. Determine the volume of earthworks excavated if the ground surface is to be leveled to elevation 10 meters. The following data are the elevations of the ground surface. So the data is given by grid. Okay, so if you want to draw that, let me show you. And that's the grid form. Okay, so we got A1, 13.3, A2, 12.9, so A1, A2, A3, A4, B1, B2, B3, B4, etc. And that those are your elevations for each point on the grid. Now the question is, how much should we excavate if you want to level all of it to 10 meters? Because as you can see, they are greater than 10 meters, 13.3 meters, etc. So we're looking for the volume of that. So let me illustrate how that looks like. So let's take this square grid, okay? So here, the two fronts are 12.9, 14.2, so let's say, so this is your grid. The first height is 13.3. So this is 13.3. Here it at 12.9 rather. 12.9. Next one is 14.2, so higher than that. So 14.2, let's say kind of like that. Next on the back we got 13.3. So like this, and then here it's 12.6. So like that. Okay, and then let's connect. Yeah. So that's what that section looks like. So once again, this is 12.6, this is 13.3. We want to level all of that to just 10. Okay, so let's say your 10 meter mark is over here. Okay, so that means this entire top portion should be removed. And we want to get the volume of that top portion. Okay, so in order to get that, the volume to be removed, let's take the extra heights. So this 12.9, you only want to get up to 10. So this extra height is 2.9. Here on the front, this extra height is 4.2. Here it's 2.6. And then over here, it's 3.3. Okay? So the volume of this red portion is just, first, multiply the base by the average height. Okay, so base, so all of these are 60 by 60. Therefore, each square or each grid is 20 by 20. So this is 20 by 20. Therefore, base is just a square. So that's side times side. And then the average of all the heights. So 2.9 plus 4.2 plus 3.3 plus 2.6 over 4. Okay, what's the answer? Correct, John and Maro. Kasople, Crystal. There. Bakit po ulit yan yung height ng figure, yung 12.9, 13.3? Ah, it's over here. I'm considering this grid. These are the front portions. So 12.9, 14.2. Okay, that's these two. And then on the back, the height of the points are 13.3 and 12.6. So here, this is 13.3, this is 12.6. Okay, so these informations are the height at each point on your grid. Okay. Yes, base area yung B. Here, this is B. So B times height average, right? B times height, that's volume of a cube or prism. And so this is 13,000 or 1,300 rather. Okay, so you can do this for the and all of the squares. So you already got one. Get the volume of this, etc. Get the sum of all of that. You'll get the volume excavated. Or a shorter way to do this is to get the pattern. Now notice, if you do that, all of your equations would involve base times summation of your points over 4. So I'll just factor that out. 20 times 20 over 4. And then the remaining portions are just sum of my points. Now you can observe how many times your point will be used in the equation. Okay, for example, here 13.3. Okay, 13.3, 12.2, 11.8, 13.9 are all going to be used just once in the equation because those points only have one grid or one square that uses it. Okay, 13.3 only has this, 12.2 only has this, etc. So meaning I'll just multiply that by 1 times 13.3. I need the excavated area. As you can see here, to get those height, I just subtracted by 10 because as given in the problem, we want to level everything to a height of 10. So anything in excess of that, we have to remove. So I'm just getting the excess. So instead of 13.3, that's 3.3 plus 2.2 plus 3.9 plus 1.8. Okay. So that's all the corner points. Now, what about all these midpoints? 12.6, 12.2, etc. Can you observe how many times will those points be used in equations for volume? Very good. Gabriel and Jasper. Twice. Sampan. Viernes. So two times. Twice, yes. So why? 12.6. Okay. So 12.6 is used by these two squares, right? 12.2 would be shared by these two squares. 11.2 is shared by these two, and so on and so forth. So it's two. Those points are used two times. So 2.6 plus 2.2 plus 2.6 plus 2.2 plus 1.2 plus 4.6 plus 1.9 plus 3.8 plus 5.8 plus 2.9. Okay? And then finally, what about these ones? How many times are we using these points? Four. Correct. Jan and Carl. Arreglado. Lahom. Four times, so four. Because as you can see, 14.2, this point is shared by these four squares, and so on and so forth. So four times 4.2 plus 5.2 plus 5.6 plus 4.4. Okay, please solve what's the answer. Correct, Kian and KB. Escobar, Kiban. Escobar, Kiban. Oh. 13,880. Okay. Meter cube. And that's it. To solve for excavations for data given in a grid manner. Ma'am, paano po nakuha yung base ng volume? Ah, here. So, it was given in the problem that is a 60 by 60 square. Okay? And these are the following points given. Therefore, each side is divided by 3, so 60 divided by 3, it's 20. So each side of your square is 20 meters. Therefore, the base of a square is just side times side, so 20 times 20. Okay. Does that answer your question? Four was taken here. Since if you do this one by one, you'll always get 4 points for each grid. You want to get the average, so all of those points will be divided by 4. So just factored out the 4. Okay. No problem. Any other questions, clarifications, concerns? Please answer in the chat. Do you have any questions? So no more questions. That's it for the topic of earthworks. Okay. So we're done for the lecture for today. Tomorrow, there will be no Zoom meeting. You can just do your fieldwork number 9. I finally uploaded the demo video data, preliminary data sheet, and manual. So it's your last fieldwork. If you've seen it, you'll see that you're just going to do leveling. Traverse leveling. So your DMD method, balancing latitude departures and all of that. Okay? So it's a bit of a long process. So you can use tomorrow to do that. And then on Thursday, there won't be any meeting. You can use our time to study for your modular exam. So there's a lot of topics for our modular exam. We have stadia theory, triangulation, horizontal curves, and this one, earthworks. I'll probably have one question for each topic. One question for stadia theory, one question for triangulation, one question for horizontal curves. It could either be simple, compound, or reverse. Okay, it's randomized. And then one example for earthworks. Yeah, it's all of the topics for module 2. We're done with module 1 already. So it's just all of the topics we discussed under module 2. That's the coverage of our exam. Yes, including, fieldwork. Yeah. Some topics from the fieldwork are included. So I think determination of height of a variable point, azimuth traverse, radial traverse,